family and to my husband that made it here. God bless you. My love you. Can we pray? Father, right now in the name of Jesus, I ask that you speak through me and speak for me. Let me decrease, Father, that you increase, God. Anoint people's hearts and ears, God, to receive this word from you, God. Bring complete deliverance on today. God, stand up in me, stretch out in me, speak through me, speak for me, God. Lord, I thank you for your presence. I thank you for your power. I thank you for your people that came on today, God. Give them special favor, God. Grant them favor with men. Grant them favor with you. Open doors that's been shut. Open up the windows of heaven. Pour them out a blessing that they won't have room enough to receive. God, I thank you for everything you've done, everything you're doing, and everything that you're about to do. And it's in the mighty name of Jesus that I do pray. Amen and thank God. If you be so kind, turn with me, please, to 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles, chapter 20. I'm going to start at verse number 2 and go to 6. Then we're going to jump down to 9 and 12. Starting at number 2, chapter 20, verse number 2. Then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea on this side, Syria, and behold, they be in Hazaton Tamar, which is in Engedi. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast throughout all of Judea. And Judea gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord, even out of all the cities of Judah. They came to seek the Lord. And Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court, and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven, and rulest not thou over all the kingdoms of the heathen? And in thine hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee? Verse 9, if when evil come upon us as the sword, judgment, or pestilence, or famine, we stand before this house and in thy presence, for thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. Verse number 12, our final verse. Our God, which thou not judge them? For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us. Neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. God's word is already blessed. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'd like to use for a subject on this morning, going through. Going through. I'm seeking, I'm searching. Can somebody help me? Where is God?
Attack.
It was three other countries coming up against Judah. You might anger, years of animosity, things that had happened from years and years of jealousy. Verse 2, it was a great multitude. It's against thee. That's personal. The king said, they're against thee. He didn't say Judah. He said thee. So what do you do when you feel a great multitude is against you? In other words, why is everyone coming up against me? So many devils can come up against us, and you feel like throwing in the towel. You feel like giving up. You feel like you're going to have a nervous breakdown, falling into depression. But you got to hold on. You can't give up. It's three things that we need to know when we're going through. Number one, you need to acknowledge when you're going through. Hey, how you doing? I'm blessed and I'm highly favored. Stop lying. We know that you're going through, because we can look at you and tell that that devil slapping the taste out your mouth. But that's okay. Go ahead and keep on lying. We can look at you and tell you don't go get your hair fixed anymore. We don't get our nails done anymore. We gain weight and then we just going through and going down. But lying, saying I'm blessed and highly favored. The Lord is good. Verse 12 says that the king acknowledged, for we have no might against this great company that cometh against us. When you say you have no might, you at your weakest point in life. You on the verge of a major breakdown. You about to say, I can't take it anymore. You saying, I can't fight anymore. This king had gotten weak. He was scared. He was down. He was saying, I can't handle this alone. When you going through, you will stop smiling like you have been smiling. When you going through, you won't act the same like usual. Sometimes we gotta open our mouth and say, I'm going through. Say, I'm going through hell. Jehoshaphat said, not only are they at us, but I don't know what to do. Once you acknowledge it, tell God who they are coming in. They coming at you. See, he was in his feelings. And when we in our feelings, we enlarge the situation. We make it bigger than what it really is. Because we all in our feelings. And sometimes all of us get in our feelings. You post on your Facebook, I'm in my feelings. I messed up today. I'm sad. I'm mad. I'm in my feelings. Get out your feelings. This is your life. This is not reality TV. You're not on Love and Hip Hop. You're not on Real Housewives of Atlanta. This is reality. This is life. Your feelings will have people come in your life for a season and get everything you got and suck the life out of you. Your feelings will have you addicted to affection from other people. Your feelings will have you addicted to attention from a certain person. Your feelings will get you a FedEx made overnight delivery because you can't wait on God. So get out of your feelings. You are not a reality star. First, acknowledge that you're going through. Second, always seek God when you're going through. When you learn like Jehoshaphat, all your enemies are at you in full attack mode. You will seek God. The Holy Ghost will drive you into seeking God. And seeking God early. Proverbs 8 and 17 reads, I love them that love me. And those that seek me early shall find me. If you don't have a personal walk with God, once you start seeking him for yourself, you will get one. Learn how to communicate. that he set himself up to seek the Lord. He didn't get mad. He didn't go out cussing. He didn't pull that nine out. It's a multitude of devils at me. And I don't need to lower my Christian standards. I don't need to stoop to their level. Can I help these sisters on today? Can I help these sisters out on today? Please do not let your baby dads get you all out of your Christian character. Not a low class, good for nothing, deadbeat baby daddy. Don't have him disrespecting you. He start calling you trifling, calling you sorry, an unfit mother, calling you the B word, calling you the H word. How many pimples have he bought for that baby? How many times did he change that baby's diaper? How many nights was he up with that baby when that baby was sick?
Still God.
Accept it. God is still God. chapter 19. Saul wanted to kill David because he let jealousy overtake him. The Bible reads in Song of Solomon 8 and 6, jealousy is as cruel as the grave.
Oh my God.
So do not kill anyone. That's not an alternative. Number two, suicide.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Elijah was running from Jezebel, asking God to kill him. 1 Kings 19 and 4. It's 121 people that kill themselves in America every day. Do not let the enemy make you destroy the temple that God made. Touch yourself and say, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. You shall live and not die. I bind the thought of suicide right now in the name of Jesus. I bind that spirit. Say, the Lord God rebuke you. The hand of God binds you. I rebuke depression and I rebuke the thoughts of suicide. Give it up. Not wanting to be here anymore. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I rebuke that tormenting demon right now. It's three people before I take my seat.